Hey, what's up, everybody? Our teams and network continue to keep people in California connected as wildfires spread throughout the state. We've extended unlimited call, text, and data relief through the 7th and announced a $100,000 grant to the California Fire Foundation to support the immediate relief efforts. Now, during our 3Q results webcast from Washington, D.C. a couple weeks ago, we gave you a look into our 5G first responder lab. That's where our teams are developing new 5G technologies that first responders like those firefighters can use. Check this out.
Today, we're at the 5G first responder lab in Washington, D.C. Here at the lab, we're working with companies to test, evaluate, and deploy 5G solutions for first responders. Let's take a look.
Sigma is a program that was developed to change the radiological detection paradigm in the United States. 5G will reduce our transmission time and allows us to transmit more data with each alert. Now you can have thousands of sensors, including man-portable, static, and vehicle-mounted sensors, reporting up into the cloud at the same time, which provides an early warning detection network for radiological hazards and threats.
The goal with PIXO VR is to create content in virtual reality that would be too difficult or too expensive to actually create in real life. 5G has allowed us to have better bandwidth and lower latency and the ability to connect multiple users into our modules. From there, we are then able to take users and assess how they perform so that when they actually go out into the field, they're ready for the on-the-job experience.
Acelon is an automated drone company. We build an automated drone solution capable of swapping its own batteries. By pairing our system with 5G, we're able to offer higher quality video, more video streams, and all of this leads to 24/7 access to an aerial asset that public safety, security don't need to be on site to operate.
NSENA's mission is to transform law enforcement training using virtual reality. Police officers have to make split-second decisions that have the impact of life and death, and they need the most realistic training possible. 5G is going to allow us to take all this hardware and move it into the cloud, and that makes it much more accessible. So it's going to really expand the use of VR.
Waycare is all about improving the safety of traffic in cities and large municipal areas. We use a lot of connected vehicle data to detect incidents and make predictions about what's going on the roads. 5G allows us to get a lot more data, so looking in much more detail, seeing a much bigger picture, at which point we can look at camera views to identify if it's something we really need to send police first responders to, and 5G will help us do that more effectively.
Hope you enjoyed taking a look at some of our technologies and applications that we're building with our 5G partners. Until next time, you're up to speed.